This movie just reconfirmed to my mind that when it comes to writing a good story, Malayalam cinema is way, way ahead. Hi everyone, welcome to I Just React and Review. My name is Ashmita and I hope you all are doing well. And last night I watched the Malayalam film Nayatte, directed by Martin Prakhar and starring Joju George, Kunchakwo Bobban and Nimisha Sajayan in the lead roles. I was completely left stunned after the film got over. This movie is the perfect example of what a good writing for a commercial cinema looks like. So yeah, lots to talk about this film, and without delaying this, let's deep dive into the detailed analysis. After watching the trailer of Nayatte, one would think that this is going to be like a chase thriller film, but in reality it is so much more than that. To put it very aptly, this is a gripping thriller that is largely rooted into the socio-political background. There is a lot of power dynamics that comes into play, or should I say a lot of power imbalance that we see throughout the run of this film. The story is about three police officers, Maniappan, Praveen and Sunita, who unfortunately get trapped in midst of a situation from which they see no way out and decide to make a run for it. What follows is an extremely rooted, realistic and gripping hunt where the crime branch is on the lookout for these three. Parallelly, we get to witness how caste politics becomes the core and heart of the storyline, and how a party might go to any extent to save their vote bank, even if it means sacrificing or convicting innocent people for their own political mileage. When you see the pain that these three police officers are going through, you would feel that this can happen to probably anybody. And even though you are a police officer, in reality, you have absolutely no power. We also get to witness that when it is election season, the police department merely becomes a puppet of the ruling party. This movie actually gives us a reality check that truth prevails is just a phrase, and the actual truth is in the hands of the one who is powerful. The writing is where the movie has completely won me over. It is written by Shahi Kabir and I have nothing but praises for the guy. He has managed to subvert the audience expectations beautifully. I mean, there were so many situations where I was thinking a scene is going to take place in a certain way, and then something completely different happens and I was left speechless. There are various aspects of the writing that I absolutely fell in love with. Number one, the build-up. You know, in Ayyappanam Koshiyam, how it was shown that one small incident can create a big ripple effect. That particular aspect was executed very well in this film. We see Joju George, who is a senior police officer, completely losing his cool and shouting at a young man, Biju, belonging to the Dalit community, when he spits onto the wall of the police compound. A series of events happen within the span of 5 minutes and a big tussle breaks out inside the police station. Biju feels highly humiliated and takes it personally, and also vows to show and assert his power on them. Now, why I specifically mentioned that he was a Dalit? Because later we see how the chief minister takes advantage of the situation in future events to preserve his vote bank. All those initial build-up scenes have been written and executed so perfectly that when the actual chase begins, you as a viewer know what the entire power dynamics is and what is the context that has been set for this hunt. Second, the power play of the ruling party versus the police department. We know for a fact that police department holds a lot of power and of course are responsible for the law and order of the state. But when it's election time, we see them become mere puppets of the political party. It's heartbreaking to see the power imbalance between the police department and the ruling party. But somewhere we know that it is true as well. A superintendent of police, who is such a powerful person in the force, is shown to just succumb to the pressure of the CM's deadline and make decisions for the benefit of the political party. Third, how media fuels the public opinion and how media houses are just interested in mere theatrics than the actual news. In fact, in reality also, we see so many coverages where the news channels start giving their verdict even before any thorough investigation or court procedures happen. In this case, the CM ensures that the media paints the three police officers as criminals and create hatred in the minds of the public against them. Fourth, the plight of the innocent and the concept of the justice that has been written and shown in this movie. It will pain the viewer to see how poorly these three are suffering because they have been made the scapegoat, when in reality they don't want anything but to go about their normal lives. The writing highlights the grim reality of the common man and how much he has to fend for justice. And even after doing everything right, he or she might not even get justice because power trumps the actual truth. The last scene where Sunita and Praveen have to make a choice for their survival is painful to watch. I mean, I was angry, I was sad, I was emotional. When the officer destroyed that memory card, that SD card, I was so angry, I wanted to punch his face. That is how invested I was in the writing and the story. Lastly, the emotional quotient. Just because it's a thriller and a political drama doesn't mean that it is devoid of human moments. There are certain scenes that just stays with you. One of the standout scenes was when Jojo George was explaining to Kunchako Bowen and Nimisha that he was not there when his daughter was born and he met her only after 15 days because he was posted in that particular area. And even after so many years, when he had actually promised his daughter that, okay, I will be there attending your function and your competition and I will watch you, he still couldn't fulfill that promise. So that regret of not being available for his daughter, not being a present father, just because he has spent his entire life in the police force ignoring his daughter's wishes and, you know, ignoring being the father that he actually wanted to be, that regret was just fantastically shown and executed by Jojo George. It's a very, very well written scene. Another scene that really stuck with me was that even though all these three people were on the run, we witness human moments where we see Kunchako Bowen go to a shop and buy a pack of cigarettes and sanitary napkins. That makes the whole thing so rooted and real. The writing is just impeccable, guys. A story can be extremely good on paper, but it is the director's job to bring that story to life and show it to the viewers on screen. And here, Martin Prakhar has done a fabulous job. His sincerity and the love for this project is evident throughout the run of the film. He has executed Shahi's writing brilliantly. He understood what was the message that needed to be conveyed. I was in absolute awe while watching the film that how well Martin Prakhar has conveyed a socio-political drama packaged into a thriller. You as a viewer are completely on the edge of your seat thinking what is going to happen next, but the clarity of thought with which the actual message has been conveyed is brilliant. At this point, I don't even think I have to say how much I love Shiju Khalid's cinematography. Every frame that has been shot is so engaging, you will absolutely not be able to take your eyes away from the screen. Again, I was thoroughly impressed with all the nighttime shots and specifically the entire sequence where the accident happened. That was executed so well. Also, the score by Vishnu Vijay complements the cinematography in every way. What really impressed me about the score is that the emotion of the person was actually captured into the background score as well. The editing was a chef's kiss. Mahesh Narayanan and Rajesh Rajendran have done a fantastic job. Every scene, the pacing, the sequence of events, everything was just perfect for me at least. There could be a percentage of people thinking that in the second half specifically, when all these three people had taken shelter into that small house, maybe the edit or the pacing was a little slow. But I necessarily don't think that. I think the pacing needed to slow down at that particular point because we see throughout the run of the film that they are just moving from point A to point B trying to escape the crime branch officers. But in that moment where they were, you know, taking solace in that small house, the interaction that all these three had, we actually see the human moment, the emotional quotient of the film. I feel it was required because that made the impact of the climax just so hard-hitting. Everybody's performance was impeccable, be it the main cast or the supporting cast, everybody shined in their role. In the supporting cast, I was particularly impressed by Jafar Iduki as the CM and Yama Gilgamesh as the crime branch officer Anuradha. Jafar Iduki was so menacing, his entire aura just screamed power, negativity, and basically ruthlessness. Then coming to the three main leads, starting from Nimisha Sajjan, she barely has any dialogues, but by keeping her mouth shut also, she says so much and expresses so much. With barely any dialogues, she has managed to convey her arc with perfection. In the beginning, we see that even though she's part of the police force, she's a scared, timid person. And then gradually, as the movie progresses, once it comes in the end where she has to make that choice, The stand she takes, you know how her character has progressed. Then Kunchapo Bowman, he's fantastic. He was the perfect depiction of a common man who wants to lead a simple life, doesn't have much ambition. Like, he wants to take care of his mother and do his duty, and that's it. And then him getting embroiled in such a messy situation, how he handles it, how he responds, is something that a normal person would do. The acting was so realistic, rooted and natural. I mean, even after being in such a messy situation, he asks his friend, and okay, tomorrow are you going to take my mother? Please, you know, he's requesting that please take my mother to the hospital tomorrow because she has that appointment. Just brilliant. But the person that impressed me the most was Joju George. He was exceptional. Every time he was on the frame, he was saying something, it just hit hard. I felt every emotion that he was trying to convey. For example, the pride he felt when he saw his daughter perform that mono acting skit and he was recording it. Then the regret that he couldn't be a good father, he couldn't be the father where he was available for his daughter. The regret that he had spent all his life in the department and listened to every superior and still this happened to me. Everything was just perfectly done by Joju George. I know a couple of you asked me to watch and review Joseph, which stars Joju George, and after watching him perform in Nayat, I am absolutely going to give it a go. Watch this movie for the brilliant direction, brilliant performances, and especially for the impeccable writing of the story. The writing impressed me so much because it is the reality that we live in. I mean, what is true anymore? Is it the things that are shown to us, or is the truth something completely different? We don't know. So yes, those were my thoughts on the 2021 Malayalam thriller come socio-political drama Nayat. I hope you've come till the end of the video and have enjoyed this review. I definitely want to know your thoughts on the film. And yep, I will see you on my next video, guys. Bye-bye.